Also, a little reminder, on Friday, myself and Dan, obviously Frontline MCOC, my co-host of the Contest Run podcast, are going to be doing a very special live stream and incursions kind of run. What we're trying to do is pair up some very unusual champions, but as well, we're both going to be rocking the Hulkbuster with maybe some other champions and figuring out whether or not they show any kind of great potency for that particular game mode. So that should be pretty exciting, and look forward to seeing you all on Friday for that live stream. Mainly about 2100 hours GMT, but I'll let you know through Marvel Contest Champions news on Friday, and as well, obviously, you follow me on social media, Discord, and everywhere else. But anyway, he's back to the champion. Now, one thing that was a bit of an issue for me when I played this was that it wasn't so suicide-friendly as it was on paper. Now, one thing that the champion is meant to boast, or was meant to boast, now I'm just going to see if I can find it, is that it was meant to reduce down poison and bleed damage. And so far, I can't actually see it. Which would help if I wouldn't scroll so fast and actually notice that it says here, incoming bleed and poison debuffs suffer minus 25% potency, making this champion relatively suicide mastery friendly. So obviously that is something to bear in mind as well. And one other thing I remember from the beta testing was that it kind of important to ramp up heavy attacks, especially putting in some very nice tasty shock debuff damage. But one of the most unfortunate pair-ups is that having Yellow Jacket seems to be kind of a necessity for this particular pair-up. So that's what we're going to do in today's video, is play about with adding Yellow Jacket to the awesomeness that is Hulkbuster. Okay, let's just go over some synergies that are kind of placed around this champion. First and foremost, obviously, Hulkbuster has got Yellow Jacket in order to kind of improve the extent of the Fury buff, or kind of like, obviously, get the Fury buff. So launching a special attack converts one armor up buff into a Fury buff lasting 10 seconds. Very important, because specials are going to be the name of the game. Now, a bit of a dicey one. Don't know if there's a real reason to having Hulk in there. Armor rating being increased helps out, obviously, to limit down damage. Not necessarily a needed thing, and we can swap out this synergy down the line. And obviously, having Hulk in seems to like double up here with these little synergies. Now, I could go for engineering experts, but you know, is it really needed? We are doing shock damage, but I don't think in the confines of the grind in this one. It's more like, say, for utility in different areas. The main thing to say is, like, Nick Fury is in. Obviously, being a hashtag hero, which Hulkbuster is, it does mean that, you know, we can kill off Nick, and therefore we can get plus 20% attack rating, which is going to be great. And the final thing is going to be this here. Now, I wanted to try this. I don't know why I didn't try this in the test server, but this is knowledge share and Iron Man Hulkbuster plus 30% special damage. So this is what I want to try out. This is the one I think I care about the most, because I want to see the extent of SP2 damage that I can do, and seeing, you know, if it ramps up a little bit more than I'd hope. But, you know, first of all, let's get in, let's kill off Nick, and then do some damage. Okay, here we go with a little fight. This one is, I'm going to describe this as take risks, get rewards. In the first instance, it's not really going to look like that. It's going to be more rewarding for me, especially because I'm gonna eat some damage attempting this kind of like constant heavy attack method. Back to the old days of She-Hulk, you'll see in a moment. Obviously, there's good spamming there, that's great, but then that happens where I'm going for the heavy attack, I'm trying to time it, and between like the AI and the way that the internet connection isn't brilliant at times, there's still a huge damage that I'm just applying there. But then again, same issue that, you know, it's a case of timing is essential. AI recovery time always kind of fluctuates at times as well. And yeah, sometimes it just doesn't work out. However though, in a moment you're going to see an amazing amount of damage off an SP1. And I'm looking forward to that moment, because I was like, wow. And I don't know if this is the Stark Spidey synergy coming in to increase that special damage, but there's going to be a moment off an SP1 you're going to see, boom. Not there, 15k, 17k, anyway, it's not there. It's going to come up in a second, and it's going to be there. 30,000 damage off an SP1. And you know, we're not down past like 40%, so we're not triggering off things when it comes to in masteries, where you'd see like an exponential increase. But still, see that 30,000 damage off an SP1. And I'm trying, like I said, guys, I'm trying to play as aggressively as possible, because maximum risk, as you can see there, spamming those heavy attacks. Again, a huge amount of damage off that SP1. It's just amazing to see that. But yeah, you've got to take the risk in order to get it. And I probably wouldn't condone 34k there. Wow, off an SP1 is incredible. Incredible amounts of damage. I don't know if I would condone the way you're playing this, but this is the thing. If you want to see huge numbers, you've got to do it. Well, you don't really have to do it. It's just, it's fun to see the big numbers and a good amount of damage under the 100 mark as well. So that's good to see. Yeah, that was a synergy that I used. I don't know if it helped towards, like, say, the attack rating side of things. I had lots of experimentation with this, and as well, obviously, Stark Spidey being in there, the ramping up of damage with Yellow Jacket being in the synergy group, and maximizing that damage potential. And I'm happy to kind of use other synergies, but man, off the SP1, non-suicide masteries, hitting off 30k. Even I think that last hit was about 34,000 damage off of like a single SP1. So it's like, it's so incredible. I love Hulkbuster at the moment. It's a great champion to have. Yeah, Mr. Hulkbuster. And do bear in mind, guys, we're going to be trying on Friday in Incursions, myself and Dan of Frontline MCC. We're going to be trying to see how far we can go, amplifying things when it comes to armor, amplifying things when it comes to, like, fury buffs. I'm going to have a Yellow Jacket, I think, in the synergy, but, you know, it doesn't matter. The fact is, the ramping up of damage, the little bit of spike of regen each battle is just going to be so darn important for, like, doing Incursions. So I'm really excited to play about this champion. Hope you have a lovely Tuesday, guys. Mjolnir is back. Check out some recent content up here. Check out some other content down there. And yeah, in different videos, I'll have different props like the Infinity Gauntlet and other things. Because it's weird and me, isn't it? Any case, see you later on. Bye-bye.